So I want to share with you a kind of summary of what I think is a proper answer to the question, what did the early church say and do with regard to the topic of killing? Now, if you focus explicitly on the issue of military service, Christian writers over the last century have in fact taken two basic positions. Some have argued that Christians before the time of Constantine were largely or entirely pacifist. Another group, I call them the small, divided, and ambiguous group, argue that in fact it's not very clear, we don't have much evidence, and in fact their position was divided and ambiguous. The small, divided, ambiguous group can be summarized by one of their best historians, John Helkelin, who puts it this way. He says, there is practically no evidence, I'm quoting, from the fathers, which would support the argument that the early church denied enlistment on the ground that killing and war were opposed to the Christian ethic. He says, the pacifist argument is an artificial construct, bringing together passages torn from their context and arranged in a way no father ever could have done. No unequivocal statement to support that argument can be found, and certainly not one of any length, such as a paragraph, three or four sentences long. So one position on the view of the early church. We have nine different Christian writers in 16 different treatises. They all say killing is wrong. There is no existing Christian writing before Constantine that argues that there is any circumstance under which a Christian may kill. Tertullian, died in 225, denounces gladiatorial contests, insisting that, quote, God puts his prohibition on every sort of man-killing. Origen, died 254, unequivocally insists that under no circumstances should Christians kill. In his commentary on Matthew, he warns Christians, quote, lest because of warfare, or the vindication of our rights for any occasion, we should take up the sword, for no such occasion is allowed by this evangelical teaching. We must use the sword, he says, against no one. No text is more clear and unambiguous and explicit about Christians being opposed to killing than the work of Lactantius. In the Divine Institutes, written in the first decade of the 4th century, during the intense persecution that's going on under Diocletian the Emperor, Lactantius discusses the topic at six different places in four different books of his great defense of Christian faith. He says Christians, quote, keep away from human blood. They are, quote, ignorant of wars, friendly even to their enemies. They do not carry on war or commit murders or even watch those who do that. In fact, they prefer to perish rather than commit an injury. When they're treated violently, he says, they respond peacefully, knowing that they have, quote, a great judge who alone always has the power of taking vengeance in his hands. And finally, we have a very interesting document. It's pre-Constantine. It's called the Apostolic Tradition. It's actually a church order that talks about how you prepare catechumens for baptism and how you ordain people in the church and so on. It probably dates from the middle of the second to the early third century. And it talks about a lot of different kinds of activities that people who are coming to seek baptism have to avoid if they want to continue in the training. And it was a three-year catechetical training in order to be baptized. He says that it says that people who are gladiators or teach gladiators or swordsmanship or military skills or weapons training should be stopped and they can't continue toward baptism. The teaching on soldiers is really interesting because it doesn't say that somebody who's a soldier and wants to be trained for baptism has to stop being a soldier. Rather, it says they have to agree never to kill. If they agree never to kill, then they can continue in preparation for baptism. Now, I think it helps us to understand the apostolic tradition's position that soldiers who become Christians may remain in the army if they agree not to kill, if we remember that many Roman soldiers in the first three centuries seldom or never fought in a military campaign. We have a couple books on the Roman army by prominent historians. one of them in a book published by Cornell University Press, says that, quote, once the soldier had been trained, he could look forward to a life which would be spent mainly in conditions of peace. He said many soldiers may never have been called upon to take part in the campaign at all. It's quite clear that by the middle of the 3rd century, and even more by the last decade or so of the 3rd century, there were significant numbers of Christians in the Roman army. There's an obvious disconnect, you can see, between the unanimous teaching of all extant Christian writers who talk about the topic of killing and the clear evidence that more and more Christians were serving in the army. It's probably not irrelevant to note that frequently over the course of Christian history, Christian laity have not lived what Christian leaders taught. Now, that's not true in the Lancaster Conference, but it's... Today, vast numbers of Christians of all traditions, alas, ignore what Christian leaders say about divorce, materialism, and other things. It would hardly be surprising if that disconnect also occurred in the early centuries. In fact, we know that both Tertullian and Origen mocked what they considered to be the weak justification of Christian soldiers for what they were doing. Every extant Christian statement on killing in war up to the time of Constantine say that Christians must never kill, even in war. That a growing number of Christians, especially in the late 3rd and early 4th century, acted contrary to that tradition and teaching is clear. Whether in doing so, they were following other Christian writers and teachers and leaders who justified their conduct, we cannot say with certainty, but we have absolutely no evidence to accept the suggestion that such teachers ever existed until the time of Constantine. Any claim that they did is sheer speculation. Thank you.